Yeah, and whenever I was in eighth grade, we were here for a birthday party. We were all hanging out, and it was about 11:30, 12 at night, and there was about 10 or 15 of us taking pictures as we walked down the bridge. And I was even listening to my music, and literally the second we stepped off onto the other side, boom, everything shut off. And even my music, I like heard like a static sound, and then everything just off.
The Goatman's Bridge was built in 1884, so it's been around for a long time. It was used as a trading route to connect cities together. Denton County has always been a place for farming and trading. Most of it used to just be farmlands, and even if you go inside Denton County, you'll see a lot of old houses and plantations that are still around. It wasn't called the Goatman's Bridge at the time. There was a man named Oscar Washburn, and he was a goat farmer, and he became known as the Goatman. And he became very wealthy in that business, and at the time was still very frowned upon for African Americans to be wealthy.
Washburn decided to put up a sign at the end of the bridge that read, "This way to the Goatman's," but this upset some of the townsfolk greatly. One night, members of the KKK dragged Washburn out of his house and hung him over the bridge. But as soon as they looked over, his body wasn't there. Out of fear, these men ran back to Washburn's house and killed his family in cold blood.
Whether that he just fell off the rope or if it was something paranormal, the fact is that people have disappeared on this bridge numerous times after that. In the mid-90s, cops found an abandoned car up there without headlights, and they couldn't find a missing person.
This bridge is especially important to a lot of people in this area, just because we do have a paranormal watch posted, and so a lot of people come here kind of looking for run-ins with paranormal activity, I think. I've lived in Denton my whole life, but I've never been to Goatman's Bridge. I know that a lot of people in Denton get hyped up about it, and I've heard a lot of stories from them. I just don't really know what to expect.
Locals would say that if you were to drive over the bridge at night with your headlights off, you would be met by the Goatman on the other side. Since 2001, the bridge has not been operational to vehicle traffic. Instead, cars drive across the new concrete and steel bridge just to the right of the old one. This doesn't look to stop the locals from enjoying the legend, though. People still cross the bridge at night on foot and also attempt to locate the Goatman's house, which is said to be down the trail from the bridge.
Have you seen anything yet?
I have not seen anything.
You have not
yet.
Seen anything yet? Has
no,
it been
I have not.
Has it been quite terrifying?
Just the mud.
And again, whether it's superstition or not, there's so much evidence that something could have happened here. And with so many people claiming to see paranormal things and just activities around here, it gives people something to, I guess, look at or try to believe.
I looked behind me because I heard a noise, and I literally saw a man dressed back in the day behind us, so yeah.
Because I have lived in Denton so long, I know that there's a lot of history behind this city. Even though there's a lot of new, construction and buildings happening, there's still a lot of history here, and I think having the Goatman's Bridge kind of keeps that history alive and kind of reminds us that this city has been here since before we were here, and it just kind of reminds us to remember the people before us.
So whether it is or not, it's here, and this legend has stood. The legend is still going. People still believe it, and that counts for something.